We've introduced this idea that counselling is a professional helping relationship. But lots of professions are a professional helping relationship, right? For example, a friend is a helping relationship. If you've got a friend that you can go talk to, then that is a helping relationship. So how does that differ from counselling? Well, in counselling, we have this idea of professionalism. So we have a set of ethics that we follow. We have boundaries, clear rules, and the way we agree that we're going to deliver therapy. And friends, they're typically there to be a shoulder to cry on, but also to offer advice and to stick in their opinion and maybe tell you what to do in times. Whereas counseling is typically more non-directive. We're there to help the clients work through their own problems rather than to act as a friend. That doesn't mean the relationship can't be friendly, but it does mean there is professionalism and boundaries in there. So what about professions like, for example, a doctor? If you go to your GP, that sounds like a professional helping relationship as well, right? And it absolutely is. But again, we can look at some key differences. So one is that in counseling, we are feelings focused. We are dealing with emotion. So you might go to your GP for a physical health problem, whereas in counseling, we're all about the feelings, all about working through those emotional problems. Another key difference is that counseling is typically delivered as a partnership. So in particular, things like person-centered counseling really focus on leveling the playing field. So when you go to your doctor, the doctor is the expert and you are the patient, and they say a bunch of stuff and we just believe them. We don't typically question them. That's less and less now that we have access to Dr. Google and we can do some research beforehand. But there is this traditional view that the doctor is the expert, and so they should be because they've spent 7 years in medical school. But with counseling, we see it more as a partnership because we see the client as the expert in themselves. And while as a counselor, we're bringing a lot of skills and a lot of professionalism to that relationship, it's not us telling the client how we are going to fix them, it's us facilitating the client fixing themselves. So we worry about power dynamics and how we can empower the client, because ultimately, if we just tell the client what they need to do, that's not going to give them a roadmap for ensuring that they stay happy and healthy forever. Whereas if we can empower them and give them the skills they need, then they can self-counsel from then on. So what about something like social worker then? That's a professional helping relationship and often is feelings focused, looking at emotion, looking at interactions, looking at behavior. Well, a key difference here is that as a counselor, we are client focused. We're really focused on that client, and that isn't necessarily true of a social worker, because social workers are far more interested in things like safeguarding. So if there are children, there are other people involved, they need to look after their welfare, they need to look after the needs of, say, the city council that's employing them. And so they don't necessarily always have the client's interests as their number one priority. That's not to say they don't care deeply about the clients, but they have other things that they need to prioritize as well. Whereas as counselors, we answer directly to the client and we're directly focused on the client's needs. So that's how counseling differs from other professions such as doctors and social workers and friends as well, in that this professional helping relationship is client focused, it's emotion centered, and it has professionalism and boundaries around it.